Friends, this is VTU e-learning and I am Dr. Basaraj discussing the subject on 18 MAT 11, that is program number 4 under VTU e-learning. Module 4 I am going to discuss, and then this is the first lecture, and module 4 consists of the differential equations and their solutions and also the applications in that particular module. Let me write in brief what are the topics I am going to cover in this module 4 under VTU e-learning program number 4. This is 18 MAT 11, which takes the title as Calculus and Linear Algebra. This is the subject title and this is the subject code and module number 4, and this is the first lecture. In this module number 4, we have ordinary differential equations, their applications. Subcontents will be like this: exact differential equation, this ordinary differential equations we call in short form ODEs, and similarly for partial differential equations we call it as PDEs. Exact differential equation, non-exact differential equation, otherwise ODE, that is a reducible exact ODE, reducible to exact ODE. This is exact differential equation, first topic. Second topic is non-exact ODE and reducible to exact differential equation. And next is Bernoulli's. Bernoulli's ODE. This is non-linear and how to convert this non-linear ODE due to Bernoulli's into linear ordinary differential equation and solution for that. And next is applications. That is first application, orthogonal trajectory, this orthogonal trajectory will be in Cartesian and polar coordinates form. And next is Newton's law of cooling. And third application, you have three applications in this ODE. First is orthogonal trajectory. We have to construct the differential equation and then we have to solve as per the property of orthogonal trajectory. And after this, LRC circuits. And the next topic is nonlinear differential equation, that is nonlinear ODE. Here we study equations solvable equation solvable for P only. And another topic, the last topic is clarets and reducible to clarets equation. In this nonlinear ODE, two topics we are going to study: equation solvable for P, where P is dy by dx, that comes in the case of nonlinear ODE, and clarets equation is some kind of differential equation due to clarets, and when it is not in the form of clarets, which represents the same standard form, we have to reduce it to the clarets form. Then what will be the solution we have to discuss. Now I shall discuss one by one the differential equation solutions, which will be taken in the first type, that is exact form, and then non-exact we'll have to identify, and then how to solve by converting non-exact into exact form, and afterwards nonlinear differential equation due to Bernoulli's, and you must be knowing the application of that linear differential equation concept in converting nonlinear into linear form. So let me discuss one by one. That is, first topic is exact differential equation. I assume that already you are familiar with the concept of differential equation, how this differential equation is to be defined, and what are the types of differential equations we are going to discuss, and where these differential equations will be applied in the case of engineering and other than engineering courses also. Now, first of all, let me define what is the differential equation. I hope since 12th standard, that means 12th class, you have been studying the definition of differential equation and the details of formation of differential equation and details of solution of differential equation. Already you must have learned the formation of differential equation from any given relation by the elimination of arbitrary constants. For example, the preamble of this topic, which let me discuss for 1 or 2 minutes. For example, if we consider y square is equal to 4ax, this is an equation which is familiar to all of you. This equation is called equation of parabola having the focus on x-axis. Then what is this, whether it is a differential equation or not? It is not a differential equation, because this relation or this equation is not involving the differential coefficient. Now you can analyze this equation, how this is appeared. That means this is explaining, like, left side y is there, right side x is there, should be a function of x, otherwise y is a function of x comma a comma 4. Like this also you can represent, but here x is what variable and y is what variable and a is what quantity and 4 is what quantity, you will have to explain. That means x is called independent variable and y is called dependent variable and a is called arbitrary constant and 4 is called, it is real constant. This is the complete analysis or complete observation of the given equation, which is not a differential equation. Now we are asked to find out or you are asked to write the differential equation for this equation of parabola, you are given with two variables, one of which is independent, where independent variable appears always, it takes its own values, then dependent variable depends on that particular symbol. Therefore, it is called independent and this is called dependent. And 4 is the real number, that is called real constant. And A is, we do not know any value we can assign, that is called arbitrary constant. Then, depending on the arbitrary number of arbitrary constants, you have to carry out the differential equation. Then here, one arbitrary constant is there. Then you need to differentiate only once, not more than that. You are allowed to differentiate only once in order to eliminate this arbitrary constant. Then this process will go like this. 2 times y in term, that is y dash, that's equal to 4 in term, should be a, 4 into a into 1, because you are differentiating this one with respect to x. Differentiating with respect to x means differentiating dependent variable y with respect to x. Then a value, otherwise together 4 value you can take, this is 4a, left side is 2y into y dash. Then in this equation you can replace, that must be y square is equal to 2 times y into y dash into x. This is the differential equation, because a differential equation is one which contains the differential coefficient in the absence of arbitrary constant. Here arbitrary constant we have eliminated and we have formed the differential equation. That differential equation will be y square equal to 2y into y dash, that is multiplied by x. Then one y you can cancel, then y is equal to 2 times x into, it is dy by, it is dx, 2 times x into dy by dx. Then that is y equal to 2 times x into dy by dx means this is a derivative and this relation is free from the arbitrary constant. Hence this is called a differential equation of the order first, because the order of the derivative depends on the number of arbitrary constants involving in that. Then solution of this differential equation is nothing but this is the solution. This is not a differential equation, this is a differential equation. This is not a solution and this is a solution. You can easily make out in any equation like this. Given equation contains how many arbitrary constants you have to verify, and then those arbitrary constants you need to eliminate, and then you need to form the differential equation by eliminating that particular arbitrary constant. Therefore, this is the order 1 and this is the degree 1, and this is called ordinary differential equation, where ordinary differential equation means the dependent variable contains only one independent variable, then the differential coefficient formed with respect to that is always called as ordinary differential equation. Therefore, this is ODE, first order, because first order derivative, first order and first degree. First order and first degree. This is called the formation of differential equation. Now, what is the solution of the differential equation? That means the solution of the differential equation is 1. It is an expression which involves the variables such as dependent and independent variables along with constants of integration. Maybe you will call it as arbitrary constant. If any value of x and corresponding value of y is given, then that constant can be calculated in particular, then it becomes the complete solution. Otherwise, it is called general solution. For example, y square is equal to 4ax is not a particular solution because you have not assigned the value of a, hence it is called general solution. Then This is the case of formation of differential equation, whereas you are going to study the solution of differential equation by various methods. By various methods means depending on the nature of the differential equation. Already you have completed two types of the differential equation solutions. One is separation of variables and another one is homogeneous differential equation and reducible to homogeneous differential equation. Now this exact differential equation, exact ODE, this is the third type of solution where a differential equation cannot be solved by separation of variables and it is not matching with the homogeneous differential equation. Then we need to analyze that differential equation, whether it is an exact differential equation or not. Then consider the ODE as M contains x comma y dx plus N contains x comma y dy equal to 0. This is equation number 1. This is a differential equation. Instead of writing like dy by dx is equal to m xy divided by n xy. Otherwise, n xy divided by m xy. In any manner you can write. So, instead of writing dy by dx in the form of dy by dx, I have taken like this. Because for some purpose, you will have to collect the coefficients of dx and coefficients of dy respectively to be defined as the quantities which are to be partially differentiated in the case of exact differential equation. Then, if this equation, if ODE 1 is said to be exact, then del m divided by del y equal to del n divided by del x. That means you have to differentiate m with respect to y and n with respect to x. If these two values are same, this implies equation 1 is said to be exact. It is not coming directly comfortable to arrange for separation of variables, and it is not also matching with the type of differential equation which is homogeneous or reducible to homogeneous, but it is the case of comparison of these partial derivatives. Partial derivatives means m contains two variables that are x and y, but you are taking differentiation only with respect to y, keeping temporarily x as constant, the value which will be same when you take differentiation n with respect to x, temporarily keeping y as constant. That means when these two values are same, then we say that the differential equation is said to be exact. Then, how to proceed further? Then the solution is given by, solution is given by integration m x comma y dx, this term. Here you have to treat y as constant. You have to treat y as constant plus of integration n x comma y, it is dy. You have to treat here the terms free from x, you have to choose. This is equal to constant. This is the solution procedure for exact differential equation. Let me repeat. The differential equation 1 is of this type, is said to be exact. Then the partial derivative when you take m with respect to y and n with respect to x, if these two values after taking the differentiations are same, then you will say that it is to be exact. When it is exact, then how to solve this one is, this is the procedure. These are all theoretical proofs from the theorems, but here we are not going to study all that theoretical proof, but we will take these statements in solving the various problems under this heading. That is m dx, where y you have to treat it as constant, and n dy, terms free from, that is x you have to select. Exactly according to this type, whenever you are given differential equation, immediately you don't be in a hurry to apply any of the methods, but you analyze the problem, you understand the problem, this problem is matching or comparable with which type of solution procedure, then accordingly you have to apply the solution procedure. Now let me give an example of solving the differential equation in the case of exact differential equation. Here the problem is like this. Solve 2x minus y square, 2x minus y square plus of 1, it is dx minus 2xy and minus y square and plus 2 dy equal to 0. Carefully observe this differential equation. This is exactly according to this form except this sign. Here plus is there, here minus is there. Better you compare any of the differential equation under this heading with the standard form like this only for your comfortable comparison. That means easier comparison, and then you can proceed for the next step of solution. Okay. Let me rewrite this differential equation. Let 2x minus y square plus 1 dx plus of 2xy and plus of y square and minus, this is minus and this is minus 2 and then dy equal to 0. 2x minus y square plus 1 dx, there is no change. I am taking this minus inside to compare with the standard form. This minus is written inside, that is minus 2xy minus y square, minus minus this becomes plus and then minus into plus, it is minus dy equal to 0. Now I will call this equation as 1. That means now I have to analyze the equation 1 for exact or not exact differential equation. Here let m x comma y equal to complete quantity which is multiplied by dx. You have to collect 2x minus y square plus 1 and n of x comma y minus 2xy plus y square and minus 2. Now you have to differentiate this first term with respect to y. With respect to y means, that is del my del y, that means x is temporarily constant. You have studied the partial differentiation concept, you recall and then you write it. That is del m by del y means x is constant, then this is equal to only with respect to y you are going to write the differentiation should be minus 2y, because x term, x is constant means temporarily, that is differentiation with respect to y is 0 and 1 with respect to y is 0 and minus y square differentiation is minus 2y. And similarly, del n divided by, it is del x. Del n divided by del x means minus of, it is 2y, because here you are taking y as constant. Y as constant, that is minus of 2y plus 0 and plus 0, because you are treating x as variable, temporarily y as constant, and this is real constant, this is another temporary constant, we made it as 0 with respect to differentiation with respect to x. Therefore, minus 2y is that, and minus 2y is that implies del m divided by del y equal to del n divided by, it is del x. Therefore, that is equal to what value? Minus of 2y implies equation 1 is said to be exact ODE. Equation 1 is said to be exact ordinary differential equation. Then what you are going to do now? If it is ordinary differential equation, then you have to solve this differential equation. Solve this differential equation means, this is the solution procedure. Solution is, this is the formula. You can write, you can consider this as a formula. Now, terms in the first one, you have to treat y as constant, and terms from the second one, you have to treat x as constant, and should be free from x, you have to consider. Okay. So, what is the first symbol? That is integration m of x comma y, as it is you write 2x minus y square plus 1, it is multiplied by dx, and plus of terms free from x. Terms free from x means, first term is multiplied by x, second term is not containing, that is x, and third term is also not containing x. Therefore, minus y square, you have to ignore this and you have to consider these two terms. Minus of 2, this is plus sign, and it is dy equal to constant. This is the solution procedure. You have to write the solution for this. Here, you have to treat y as constant. You have to treat y as constant means, you have to integrate only with respect to x, that is 2x square divided by 2 minus y is constant, and x into y square, and plus of 1 should be x, and plus of, with respect to y only you have to integrate, y cube by 3 minus of 2y equal to constant. Then 2 cancels, and finally you get the solution x square minus x into y square plus x and plus y cube and divided by 3 minus 2y equal to constant. This is the final solution. Three steps are more important. One is, you have to reset the problem according to the standard form, that is mdx plus ndy is equal to 0. And next step is, you have to collect the values of m and values of n, value of n separately, and then you have to write the proper differentiation for m with respect to y, keeping x as constant, and you have to differentiate n with respect to x, keeping y as constant. I shall consider another example. X cube minus 3x into y square, that is dx plus sum of y cube minus 3x square y dy equal to 0, comma y 0 is equal to 1. Comma y 0 is equal to 1 means it is some condition given so that you can calculate this constant value. Constant of integration is arbitrary constant value. You can calculate in particular and then substitute in that. Let us compare this with the standard form, that is m dx plus n dy is equal to 0, like this in the solution. Let m dx, that means m is a function of x comma y, plus n dy equal to 0. Then here x cube minus 3 x square x into y square, it is dx, plus y cube minus 3 x square y into dy equal to 0. Then what is m? M x comma y equal to x cube minus 3 x into y square, and n x comma y equal to y cube minus 3 x square y is that. So according to the exact differential equation, the necessary condition, that is necessary condition to check the partial derivatives, and sufficient condition is nothing but integration. That is necessary and sufficient condition. These things in the theoretical discussion are available in the theorem. Okay. So now you have to differentiate this m. That is del m y, you have to write del y. Here you are taking x as constant. Del m by del y means this is 0. With respect to y means minus of 6 x y, and del m by del x, this is y is constant. Y is constant, first term is 0. With respect to x means 3 into 2, it is 6xy. Since both the values are same, you will say that it is called exact differential equation. Which one? This is equation 1. This implies ODE 1 is said to be exact. ODE 1 is said to be exact differential equation. Now, what is the next step? We have to solve the differential equation by considering the sufficient condition. Solution of 1 is given by integration m x comma y, it is dx, plus n x comma y, it is dy, equal to constant. Here y is to be taken as constant, and here terms free from x. Then how to write? This is integration x cube minus 3x into y square should be dx, and plus of terms free from x. Only one term is that. This is multiplied by x and this is free from x. Therefore, integration y cube and dy equal to constant. Then you need to write the solution. Integration here, treating y as constant, this must be x to the power of 4 divided by 4 minus 3x into y square. 3x into y square gives with respect to x 3, x square, it is y square, and divided by 2, and plus of y cube it is y to the power of 4 by 4 equal to constant. This is the solution of the differential equation and this is called general solution. A general solution is one which contains still the value arbitrary constant which is not calculated in particular. Now, what is to be done? We have to make use of this, make use of that initial condition. This is called initial condition. Y at, this is called y at x naught equal to y naught, first condition. Like this, how many conditions are given? And it all depends on the so many constants. Now, only one condition and we have only one constant. So that you can calculate the value of constants. What you have to do? At x equal to x naught, 0, and y is equal to y naught, that is equal to 1. You have to substitute in this solution, proceed in this step, you have to substitute. What you are getting? Here, wherever x is there, you make it as x naught and substitute as 0. Wherever y is there, y naught, you make it and then put it as 1. Here, it is 1 by 4, 3 by 2 with minus, and x is 0, and y is 1 square, and plus of 1 to the power of 4 by 4 is equal to constant. Like this, it is there. Then, 1 by 4, and this term becomes 0 because 0 is multiplied and plus of 1 by 4 equal to c. Therefore, 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 means 2 by 4 equal to c. Then c is equal to, it is 1 by 2. C is equal to 1 by 2 and then when c is equal to 1 by 2 means in the solution, final solution which we have written, and this becomes the complete solution. X to the power of 4 by 4, 3 by 2, x square, y square, plus y to the power of 4 by 4 is equal to 1 by 2. This is the complete solution. That means particular solution. This is general solution. General solution. This is particular solution. So, like this, any number of problems you can consider. Still, I will continue one more problem on this exact differential equation. Solve. Y cos x plus sin y plus y dx plus of sin x plus x cos y and plus x, it is dy equal to 0. This is similar, but with the trigonometric functions you have a problem and then you need to solve this one. Suppose if you start thinking the first method, that is separation of variables, can you apply separation of variables for this problem? Why we are directly going for exact differential equation verification? Because separation of variables means you cannot separate from this type of terms appeared and you cannot group that x terms in one side and y terms in the another side, so that it is not matching with separation of variables. And a homogeneous differential equation, for example, this is y degree 1 and this is x degree, y degree 1, and here cos x is there and degree is not same throughout the differential equation, hence it is not coming in homogeneous differential equation. Even it is not a non-homogeneous differential equation, because in the case of non-homogeneous differential equation, the coefficients of dx and dy, the coefficients of dx and dy must be containing the equations of straight line. Equations of straight line means of that kind, ax plus by plus c, and here also ax plus by plus c type. Okay, of that type, if the terms are there, then only you can say that it is matching with the equations reducible to homogeneous. But here, now the third method, when you go on studying various methods for solving, then by inspection method you must be in a position to judge this differential equation comes in which type, and the accordingly the solution procedure is what. If you identify this much in any mathematical problem, that is nothing but 50% of the solution, because when once you have the, you are strong enough in identifying the problem and you are good enough in solving the final steps also, then what is this what is the comparison here with respect to the standard type, that is mdx plus ndy equal to 0. Let me discuss with that. Let m x comma y dx plus n x comma y dy equal to 0. This is plus sign. Exactly, without making any changes, we can compare m and n values in this differential equation which is given to us. Then what is m and n? Let m x comma y equal to y cos x plus sin y plus of y, and n x comma y is equal to sin x plus x cos y plus of x, that is for n x comma y, when you compare with standard form. Then here, as per the necessary condition, del m by del y you are taking, there you are treating y x as constant. X as constant, then x as constant means only with respect to y you have to differentiate, that is cos x, and with respect to x as constant, only with respect to y you are taking differentiation, cos y, and plus 1. X is constant, cos x you keep as it is, y with respect to y is 1, and sin y becomes cos y, and y becomes with respect to y is 1. Then del n by, it is del x equal to cos x. Here you have to take y is constant. Then here rho y, sin x becomes cos x, and with respect to x means it should be cos y and plus 1. Cos x plus cos y plus 1, cos x plus cos y plus 1. Both the values are same. Implies del m divided by del y is equal to del n by del x. This implies ODE 1 is said to be exact, is said to be exact, then the solution is given by, solution is given by integration, that is y cos x plus sin y plus of y into dx. Here you have to take y is constant plus of terms free from x, you have to choose in the second integral, that means second term of the integration step, terms not containing x. This is containing x, this is containing x, this is containing x. There is no term containing not containing x. Then integration of 0, this is dy equal to constant. That's all the solution. Then you have to integrate with respect to x only, keeping y as constant. Therefore,
with respect to x means cos x integration is y sin x. Y will be constant carried as it is, and with respect to x means x into sin y, because sin y totally is a constant, plus xy plus of c1 equal to c. This is the final solution. Otherwise, instead of leaving two constants in the final solution, you can make it as one constant, that is y sin x plus x sin y plus xy plus a equal to 0, where a equal to c1 minus c, like that, because both are arbitrary constants and you can put final value as another constant. Therefore, this is the solution for the differential equation which is given, where it was identified as exact differential equation. Similarly, one more problem I will take, and then I will move on to the next discussion. Solve 2x by y cube dx plus solve y square minus 3x square divided by y to the power of 4 and dy equal to 0. This is the another problem, little different type. Let me attach this one. Here it is given as y 1 equal to 2. To find the arbitrary constant, some condition is given in the solution. This is exactly according to m dx plus n dy equal to 0, so that you can directly collect the value of m separately and value of n separately. Afterwards, you write the differential coefficients for both with respect to y separately and then x separately as per the necessary condition. Okay. Let m dx plus of n dy equal to 0. Here, m dx means m value, it is 2x divided by y cube, and n x comma y equal to y square minus 3x square and divided by y to the power of 4. Then del m by del y, you have to take del m by del y means with respect to y only you have to differentiate, keeping x as constant. Okay. So, keeping x as constant means what you are going to write? Now, x is constant. With respect to y only you have to take differentiation. This y cube will be taken. That is, in another form you can write y to the power minus 3 in this case. When you take like this, differentiation minus 3 into 2x minus 3 into 2x y to the power minus 3 minus 1, that is minus 4, that is equal to minus 6x divided by y to the power of 4. This is the derivative. Next, del n by, it is del x. First term is 0 and second term with respect to x means it is 0 minus 6x divided by y to the power of 4, because y is constant. In the earlier one, x was constant, and in this present case, y is constant. Then this is equal to minus 6x divided by it is y to the power of 4 minus 6x y to the power of 4 minus 6x y to the power of 4 both are same here. Del m divided by del y is equal to it is del m by del x. This implies equation 1. This is the equation 1 is exact. This is the exact differential equation. Then what is the next step is what? What is the solution of this differential equation? Solution of 1 is given by integration of the first term, that is 2x divided by y cube dx. Here you have to take y is constant and plus of integration terms free from x. Terms free from x means, for example, y square minus 3x square divided by y to the power of 4 can be rewritten as y square by y to the power of 4 minus 3x square by y to the power of 4. If you split separately, then terms free from x means the first term is not containing x, so that you can place here y square divided by y to the power of 4, it is dy equal to constant. Then you need to integrate your terms free from x we have taken. You need to integrate every term and afterwards you apply this condition. Okay. Then what is the integration you are going to write? So first term integration with respect to x only, that is 2 times x square divided by 2 y cube and plus of integration 1 divided by y square dy equal to constant. This 2 cancels, I hope, x square by 2, yes. Then x square divided by y cube and here plus of, if you take this y to the numerator as y to the power minus 2. So integration y to the power minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1. And equal to constant. Then the final solution step is that is x square by y cube, x square by y cube and plus of y to the power minus 1 divided by minus 1 equal to constant. Otherwise, x square by y cube minus of 1 divided by y equal to constant is the general solution, final solution with arbitrary constant. Now, to find the value of this arbitrary constant, you must make use of this given initial condition. What is that? At x equal to x naught, that is equal to 1, and y is equal to y naught, that is equal to 2. Then this step gives x equal to 1, 1 square divided by it is 2 cube and minus of 1 divided by 2 equal to constant. Then you need to simplify this. First term is 1 by 8. 1 by 8. And minus 1 by 2 equal to constant. Then 8 is the LCM, that is 1 minus 4 equal to C. Therefore, C takes the value, that is minus 3 by 8. Therefore, final solution with the inclusive of this value of the constant C, final solution we have to write like this, that is x square divided by y cube x square divided by y cube minus 1 divided by y equal to minus 3 by 8. This is the final solution with the inclusive of arbitrary constant.
Like this, you can solve, even you can try extra problems. I will be writing in the next discussion. So you can solve or you can verify the differential equations with the exact differential equation, with exact differential equation type, you can verify. Now, the next discussion, when this differential equation is not giving the values of del m by del y and del n by del x, which are not the same, then we cannot call it as exact differential equation. Then what is the next step to solve such differential equations when we cannot solve by separation of variables directly? We cannot accept that differential equation as homogeneous differential equation where degrees are not same, and where those differential equations are non-homogeneous are also not coming in that group, and also they are not of the exact differential equation. Then we can assume or we can expect they may be non-exact differential equation when these differential coefficients are not matching. So when they are not matching, then we need to take the alternative method to solve the differential equations. There are totally 4 to 5 techniques are there. Only 4 techniques you can discuss one by one. One is the difference you have to take between the derivatives and divide by n if it allows from the differential equation. Then you need to calculate the factor called integrating factor, where that integrating factor makes the given differential equation, which was supposed to be non-exact, that will be converted to exact differential equation. When once we convert the differential equations into exact differential equation form, thereby immediately we can write the solution by integration procedure. Therefore, this is how we are going to start, or we are going to learn the differential equation at solution methods at various types of solution procedures. Okay, so in the next discussion I will continue these non-exact differential equations, how they are going to be reduced to the or convert to the exact differential equation, and then we can solve.